A local group of flour millers says Russia's termination of its grain deal with Ukraine won't be felt yet here in the Philippines. The Philippine Association of Flour Millers says the country has a buffer stock of wheat good for 90 days. But it notes there could be indirect effects from Russia's move in the long run.
Mangyayari kung mababawasan o mawawala ang trigo galing sa Ukraine na papuntang North Africa at itong mga Middle Eastern countries. Itong mga bansang ito, hahanap naman ng ibang sources. So ang sources na available, yung kinukuhaan natin. US, Canada, Australia, and so on. So ang mangyayari, yung binibili natin, bibili na rin nila.
Okay.
Iagaw sila dun sa supply natin.
Russia halted its participation in the deal this week, which lets Ukraine export grain through the Black Sea. That decision raised fears food prices would again spike. Russia launches retaliatory strikes on Ukrainian ports. The attacks hit targets in the Black Sea ports of Odessa and Mykolaiv. This came just days after Russia quit a deal that allowed safe export of Ukraine grain for the past year. The United Nations quick to condemn the attack, warning the move may constitute a violation of international humanitarian law.
The Secretary General strongly condemns the Russian attacks against port facilities in Odessa and other Ukrainian ports on the Black Sea. The attacks contradict the Russian Federation's commitment under the Memorandum of Understanding with the United Nations, which states that, quote, the Russian Federation will facilitate the unimpeded export of food, sunflower oil, and fertilizers from Ukraine-controlled Black Sea ports. The Secretary General also recalls that the destruction of civilian infrastructure may constitute violations of international humanitarian law.
India orders the halt of its largest rice export category in a move that will roughly halve shipments by the world's largest exporter of the grain. The government says it was imposing a ban on non-basmati white rice as retail rice prices climbed 3% in a month after heavy monsoon rains caused significant damage to crops. India accounts for more than 40% of the world's rice exports, and low inventories with other exporters mean any cut in shipments could inflate food prices already driven up by Russia's invasion of Ukraine. The move now triggering fears of further inflation on global food markets. A very lucky Powerball player from Southern California beating extreme odds to become the newest billionaire in the United States. Wednesday night's draw ended a streak of 38 straight drawings without a grand prize winner. The winning ticket holder has yet to come forward. The ticket was sold at the Las Vegas or Las Palmitas mini market located in Los Angeles.
We don't know if that person lives here locally, if it's a group, if they were passing by. They have to claim their prize, and then we have to spend time vetting the winner to make sure it is the right person. Integrity and transparency are incredibly important to us, so we will probably not know for months and months.
The winner can either accept $558 million in cash or can choose to receive the estimated $1 billion before taxes in 29 annual payments. Only two other Powerball jackpots have reached the $1 billion threshold. The largest was for a whopping $2 billion, also won by a player near Los Angeles. Manila's Defense Secretary says the Philippines is keeping a close eye on Taiwan amid the threat of an invasion from China. Secretary Teodoro says government is preparing contingencies related to that possibility, as well as other conflicts in the region.
First and foremost, we really have to make an assessment whether such is likely or not. Nonetheless, we continue to plan on all contingencies, not merely any flashpoint between China and Taiwan, but any contingency within the theater. And it's a multi-agency effort, not only the defense effort. That is a thing that we continue to monitor daily. And hopefully the engagements bilaterally between the United States and China leads to a diffusion of tensions in that theater.
China has been claiming Taiwan as its own territory despite the island's strong objections. It has increasingly entered Taiwan's airspace in recent years and has exerted pressure on countries to sever ties with the island. China's never renounced the use of force to bring Taiwan under its control. Over now to the West Philippine Sea issue, the outgoing chief of staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines says the leadership change in the military was triggered by the need to focus more on protecting Philippine waters. General Andres Centino is set to take on a new role as the presidential advisor on the West Philippine Sea. He aims to formulate a new strategy in dealing with maritime tensions with China.
Our leadership has deemed it important na mabigyan ng focus and importance yung the way we address the issues there in a bigger scale. And that's why they thought of creating an office of the presidential advisor. It will be combination or a mix of everything that we can do. It doesn't have to be military alone. It has to be a combination of efforts. That's why the task force would most likely be interagency, meaning there will be inclusion among other agencies to compose the task force.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. set to make a three-day state visit to Malaysia a day after his second State of the Nation address. The Foreign Affairs Department says the state visit will be from July 25 to 27. Marcos will be meeting with Malaysia's King as well as its Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim. The DFA adds the President and his economic team will be advancing Manila and Kuala Lumpur's bilateral trade. Investment pledges also expected during the visit.
This reciprocal visit between the leaders of both countries in 2023 is a testament to the reinvigorated relationship between the Philippines and Malaysia. It is also timely as the Philippines and Malaysia will mark 60th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between the two countries.
Marcos will also meet with the Filipino community in Malaysia to share government's plans for migrant workers.